Hello everyone. Now we are going to start with the next topic, that is your free consent. Now this free consent, this is as per your section 13 of your Indian Contract Act of 1872. Now, it is not just that we have to require to understand only offer, acceptance, your legal obligation, consideration, but there is one more thing that is plays a very important role when it comes to your enforceability of a contract, and that is your free consent. Now, basically, free consent ka agar matlab main batana chahun, to that is nothing but your willingness to enter into a contract. So, your consent, that means to say willingness, meri ichha. That plays a very important role. Now, law says ki agar two person are entering into a contract, there should be their willingness, and that willingness should be not forcible or not enforced by any other thing. That has to be freely been obtained. So if I want to purchase 2 kgs of tomato, that should be all my willingness. There should not be forcibility ki okay nahi nahi aapko kharidna hi padega. There should not be any such kind of forcibility. Okay, when we can say that there is no free consent, that has been stated in your 5 points, which says, if my contract has been entered either by coercion, undue influence, misrepresentation, mistake or fraud. अगर इन पांचों में से किसी के भी थ्रू अगर मेरा विलिंगनेस ऑब्टेन किया है, आई कैन से माय इंटेंशन वाज नॉट देयर एंड स्टिल आई वाज बीन फोर्स टू एंटर इनटू द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड आई कैन कैंसिल द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू कैंसिल द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इट कैन बी सेड दैट माय कॉन्ट्रैक्ट वाज अ वॉइडेबल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. नाउ दीज देयर आर फ्यू द टर्म्स, वॉइडेबल, void, illegal, unenforceable. These terms I am going to frequently keep on using. That is nothing but your different types or the classification of contract. When we are going to do that point, automatically you will correlate with these topics. So coming to back to your free consent, it says coercion. Now, simple way, I know these are the Latin terms which you will not be able to understand, but there are few techniques through which we can remember these points. So coercion, it can also be called as physical force. Undue influence, it can also be called as mental force. Misrepresentation, it is like not purposely deceit or not intentionally, or there was some kind of misunderstanding, you can say. When it comes to your fraud, it is purposely deceit. Jaan boojh karke kisi ko dhoka dena, that is known as purposely deceit. And last one, mistake. I think mistake everyone knows as galti. Okay, so now when it comes to your coercion, physical force karna, kisi ko gun point pe rakke kaam karwana, kisi ko kidnap karke, any such kind of activity through which my capacity, my enforceability, my willingness was never there, but still I had to enter into the contract. Let me give you the simplest example. We all must be knowing about the celebrities Shah Rukh Khan and Salman Khan. They are dispute and all. Let's not go into that. We are just giving you an example, okay? So now there was a dispute between Shah Rukh Khan and Salman Khan. Salman Khan wanted the property of Shah Rukh Khan. He was very much interested into the house of Shah Rukh Khan, that was your mannat. So one day Salman Khan approached Shah Rukh Khan that I want to purchase. So Shah Rukh Khan said, no, I am not interested to sell it off, so please thank you. To which Salman Khan thought of ki, no, I want this property, I am giving you the opportunity to purchase it for 10 crores of rupees. So over which again Shah Rukh Khan said, no, sorry, I am not interested. So which what Salman Khan did, he actually made someone else to kidnap Ibrahim, youngest son of Shah Rukh Khan. To which Shah Rukh Khan had no other option but to enter into the contract. He had to say ki, okay, fine, whatever it is, I am ready to continue with the contract and I am ready to sign the papers. To which he actually signed it and he had given the property. In the future, he realized ki, no, that was my property, my intention was never there, but still I was made. Forcibly I was made. So can law protect me for the same? Yes, the law says if anyone has obtained your consent but it was not free, and at the same time it was being obtained through some kind of physical force, you can claim for the same and it can be called as a coercion. So law absolutely, possibly, never allows anyone to enter into the contract. So if anyone obtains your physical force, any contract, then it can be called as a voidable contract. Next scenario, that is undue influence. Undue influence, that can also be called to as a mental force. Mentally forcing someone to enter into the contract. That is, I can give you the example of relationship of your student and a teacher, a doctor and a patient, a tantric baba and a normal person. These are the scenario where physical force is not there, but there is some other kind of force, and that is a mental force. Jahan par ek person is in a dominating position over the other party and he plays with his mindset in such a manner, they enter into the contract. Baba tantric, I was not having proper job and all, so I had no other option. Ek din ek tantric baba ne mujhe bola, listen bachcha, agar aapko apni job chahiye, property wapas chahiye, to aap ek kaam karo, apni jitni bhi gold, jewelry and cash and whatever you are having, give it to me. I was very much into bad scenario. Maine सब कुछ वापस दे दिया एंड दैट इज वेयर आई एंटर इनटू द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड लेटर ऑन व्हेन एवरीथिंग उसने ना तो मेरा सॉल्यूशन मुझे दिया ना मुझे जॉब मिली ना कुछ हुआ लेटर ऑन एट द फर्दर फ्यू सिचुएशन आई रियलाइज कि नो दैट वाज नॉट व्हाट आई वांटेड कैन आई फाइल अ केस अगेंस्ट हिम एंड कैंसिल द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ही विल से नहीं मैंने तो कोई फोर्स ही नहीं किया था बट यस लॉ सेज दिस वाज अ मेंटल मैनिपुलेशन विद द पर्सन देयर वाज सम काइंड ऑफ पोजीशन डोमिनेटिंग पोजीशन where he can play with your mind and you have to enter into the contract. Similar manner, let's take the example of a doctor and a patient. Doctor, I had gone to a doctor. I was having a stomachache. Okay, that is where I went to the doctor and he said, okay, please take out a report. I was like, okay, fine. I'm suffering with some disease, so I will take out. I'm not a technical person. I'm not a science person. So I was not able to understand what is there in the reports. He sees the report. Oh, there's a lump in your stomach. You had to get it or rid out of it as early as possible. Otherwise, it will get burst and tumko ho sakta hai cancer ho jaye ya any other disease ho jaye. I was very scared. I was of the opinion ki agar main wapas se koi doctor ke paas jaungi, so ho sakta hai mera time waste ho jayega. I had to again suffer with the same thing. So I entered into the contract. He did my operation, everything he did. And after a few days, again, I faced the same problem. In future, I approached to another doctor. And that is why I came to know that there was no lump, there was nothing in my stomach. Can I now file a case against that doctor? Yes, absolutely. Doctor will say ki nahi maine to thodi na physical force kiya tha maine thodi na bola tha gun point pe aapki marzi thi kisi aur ko approach kar lete the but that was a point of a some kind of mental force so this is where the law protects you ki agar aapko jis din realize hota hai you can cancel the contract and you can say ki yes there was no free consent of mine now coming to the fourth part that is sorry third part that is your misrepresentation So when you say misrepresentation, it is kind of a misunderstanding where the party's intention was not actually to deceive. Both the parties were at their own mindset and as per that they have entered into the contract. But because of some kind of misunderstanding, they entered into the contract and later on when they realize it, can they cancel the contract? Yes, this benefit due is been given by the law and they can cancel the contract. And that is where you can say it was a misrepresentation. Simple example, there was a bride's family and a groom's family. Bride's family had absolutely mentioned about it. We want a boy who is a CA. At the groom's family, they actually understood ki, okay, our son is doing a CA. So fine, they will be okay with it. With this, bride and groom get married. In future, the bride realizes, no, he's not a CA. He's actually doing a CA. So can she cancel the contract? Yes, absolutely. Now, first of all, it is very important for me to tell you ki yes, marriage is a contract. Now that is something separate for you to understand. Just for the time being, just understand ki in this scenario, yes, bride can cancel the contract. There is no fraud which is done, but there was a manipulation in the understanding of the words, and that is where law gives you the opportunity to cancel the contract. Now this is up to you. You can continue with the marriage. You will be like saying, okay, fine, whatever was my luck, I will continue, or you can cancel the contract. Next part, the fourth part, is your fraud. Fraud means to say purposely deceiving someone, जानबूझकर के किसी को धोखा देना, और यू कैन से इन माई इंटेंशन वॉज एक्चुअली कॉजिंग हार्म टू द अदर पार्टी, देन आई कैन से इट इज अ पर्पसफुल डिसीट और अ फ्रॉड. इन हिंदी द जनरल टर्म्स वी कैन से इट इज धोखा देना पर्पसली. ओके, नेक्स्ट नाउ मिस्टेक. मिस्टेक दैट इज मिस्टेक ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, मिस्टेक ऑफ एक्चुअली फैक्ट, मिस्टेक ऑफ लॉ. Now, what the law says, if you have done any mistake with the understanding of the legality of Indian law, then you will not be pardoned. You will have to pay the penalties for the same. Obvious baat hai. Agar aap jaise helmet pehen ke jana, if you are driving a Activa or a, you know, scooty or something, you will have to wear a helmet for the same. But if you are not wearing and you will say, and a particular policeman catches you, you can't say ki mujhe nahi pata tha, main law ke bare mein janta hi nahi tha, sorry. Over here, automatically you will be asked to pay the penalties. But similar manner, if I have done some kind of mistake in the law of the other country, yes, I can be pardoned. If I am going in the other country and वहाँ पे मैंने कुछ गलती किया, I can be pardoned for the same. So mistake of Indian law, it is not been allowed to do so. You will be punishable. But if the other country's law, you can be, you know, pardoned for the same. Mistake of fact, if it has been done by both the parties, दोनों ने पार्टी ने अपनी अपनी तरह से गलती की. For example, I have entered into a contract with a farmer, जिसने मुझे assurity दी थी कि जैसे अभी farm grow हो जाएंगे उसकी cutting करेंगे and I will supply you the grains. Okay, fine. With this, actually there was a mistake when we were entering. उस time पे mistake हो गई कि grow or the grains were already destroyed in the farm because of some kind of natural calamity. Now, this was the mistake of the fact which was not known to the both the parties. Automatically the contract cannot be coming into the existence. This was your full-fledged concept of your free consent, where law simply says if the free consent is not there, the parties can cancel the contract. The party who has suffered can cancel the contract and it will be called to be as a voidable contract. Again repeating, the five things are coercion, that is physical force, your undue influence, that is mental force, your misrepresentation, that is your misunderstanding, your fraud, that is purposely deceiving someone, and mistake, that is your misunderstanding where the facts of the case or the laws of the case. Thank you, we'll stop it here.